Hey everyone, it's Grace from Kapwing, and today I'm going to introduce you to a screen and video recorder that works completely online in your browser. You'll be able to use this tool to record your entire screen or even just a single tab in your browser. You can also record your face at the same time to achieve an effect that looks like this, where your video and your screen recordings are put together. This effect is commonly used in things like reaction videos, tutorial videos, or even virtual presentations. After you record, you'll also be able to edit the videos all in one place, where you can do things like trim the video clips, rearrange where exactly on the screen your different clips are, and then add things like text or images, overlays, and even transcribe the subtitles or translate the subtitles to another language. This tool is free if your video is 7 minutes or less, and if you want to make some bigger videos, check out our Kapwing Pro pricing information to see more. If you're new here, don't forget to subscribe. We make new videos on video editing and social media content creation every single week. So hit that button and let's get into it.
Okay, so to get to the screen recorder, click the first link in the description below. If you've never used Kapwing before, just click Start Editing on the homepage and you'll be taken to the inside of our editor, which it looks like this. So to actually use the screen recorder, all you have to do is just click Record here. And there are a couple options, so record screen is the one I'm covering today. The other ones are pretty straightforward though. You can just record with your camera to record your face, or you can just record audio. So for the screen recorder, just click it, and then there are a couple options that you can play around with. So if you want to record your screen and your face at the same time, for example, if you're doing a reaction video or tutorial video or something, you can toggle this on. So I'm gonna toggle it on just to show what it's gonna do. So now you can see your camera preview down here in this window. You can also change which camera input it's taking from. So I'm just using the camera from on my computer, but if you have an attached camera that you've hooked up to your computer or something like that, you can choose that one. And then if you want to include sound, you would toggle this on as well. So in addition to recording your screen and your face, it's also gonna use your microphone. So then you can select which microphone you want to use. I'm just using my built-in computer microphone. And then if you do want to include the audio, for example, if you're gonna play a video while you're screen recording and you wanna include the audio from that video, then you can toggle this one on and then read the instructions. Make sure to click the share audio checkbox when you actually select the tab that you're going to choose. So then once you've got all your different settings all good, then you can click start recording. This window comes up where you can choose what part of your screen it's gonna record. So this first option, your entire screen, I'm actually hooked up to another monitor, so that's why there's two screens here. To choose one, just click it, and then you would click share. The other options are your whole application window, so you'd click that and click share, or if you have multiple tabs open, you can just select a single tab. And that's what that audio, that tab audio was referring to before. So if I wanted to just record only my tab, not the background of my desktop or anything like that, I could just click this and click share audio and then share, and it would take from the audio of my tab. I'm just gonna choose my entire screen for now. I'm gonna click screen one and then click share. As you can see down here, it says Kapwing sharing your screen. It's recording, so all you have to do to stop recording is click this stop recording video button. And you can do anything here. You can go to new tab. So if I was watching this video, playing in the background while I'm speaking and it's recording the screen and my face. And basically just do your thing on your computer and it's recording you and the screen. Then when you're ready to stop, just click stop recording. And your video of your face and your screen should just come up right inside the studio here. These are the final recorded videos. Now, once your recording is done, you can actually start editing the files before saving them. You can do things like change the output size. For example, if you did a screen recording, you want to upload it to YouTube, you could click the 16:9 format, which is the YouTube format. If you click lock ratio on these videos, it will retain the size of the original file so that you can resize it proportionally. Another thing you can do is just change where these videos are on the screen completely. So I can just move around my face to where I want it to be. Maybe I want to make it bigger. And then if you want to see what you recorded, you can just go down here, click the play button.
As you can see down here, it says Kapwing sharing your screen.
And this is just the recording of what I did just now.
All you have to do
if you want to trim the videos, you can click the video and then click trim on the side here. Or do things like adjust it, crop it, round the corners of the whole video. But you can also edit the videos in the timeline. So click the timeline and then these two video files show up as separate videos. So you can edit, split the clips, trim them separately, and then line them up. If I wanted to trim down some of the beginning part of the two videos, I can just click the ends and drag them down. And I can do that with both of them. And then to do things like split the clips to trim a section in the middle, you can just move the seeker to where you want in the video and click the video and then click split. And then it turns into two different videos that you can then trim down the ends of that. Other things you can do are upload photos or other videos or audio files or GIFs and move them around on the screen here and time them out in the timeline. You can add things like text and search for images right in this editor. You can also add subtitles, which is a big one, especially if you did a screen recording video that you want people to be able to see and what you're saying. So click subtitles, and then you can either add them manually, line by line, or you can just click auto-generate. You can actually translate the words you're saying into another language completely. Just by clicking this box. I'm just gonna transcribe what I'm saying in English, which is the language I'm speaking, so I'm just gonna click auto-generate here. So my subtitles have loaded, and you want to make sure that you go through them and make sure that everything is spelled correctly and there's no errors in the transcription. But basically, each line of subtitles will have the text and then the timing down below here, and that is where you can edit. So you can change when and where they stop and start, and then change the text. You can also just change the whole appearance of the subtitles using options on the left side here. Then you can click done. Another thing you can do here is add things like overlays to your recordings. If you see on YouTube or even Twitch and other platforms, sometimes people will put a little banner behind their webcam recorded video, or they'll have a border around the whole video. You can do that really easily here using either uploaded images that you provide yourself, or by finding images, or by using things like elements back here where we have like these rectangle. So I'm gonna just quickly search in the images tab for a gradient just to show what I'm talking about. I'm gonna choose this one and then size it down and send it backward behind my video. So we have this border behind here, and I'm just gonna resize it so it kind of makes this outline around my face video. So as the video plays,
sharing your screen. It's recording, so
this looks pretty fancy for something that I did in like a minute just by putting this little box behind it. And you can do the same with the actual video recording over here. I'm gonna put it on fill because then it will resize to the exact shape of the screen, and then copy this, the whole screen size, and send it all the way back. So now we have this border around the whole video in addition to the border around my face video.
All you have to do to stop recording is
that just brings it up a notch in terms of your branding and how professional it can look. You can add your colors and branding and graphics so that it really shows that this is a video that you made. Once you're ready to download the final product, you first need to hit this red export video button. You'll be on this loading page for a few moments while your video processes, and then your video will be done and ready for downloading. If you notice a small watermark that says Kapwing here, you can remove that for free. Just sign into your Kapwing account and there should be a button up here to do that. Then you can just click download and the video will save to your device as an MP4. And to share the video with other people, you can simply just share this link to this page. So this link right up here, just send that to others and they'll be taken to the video to watch it themselves.
If you got this far in the video, let us know what kinds of videos you're making with the screen recording tool in the comments below. And make sure to like and subscribe to our channel. We put out new videos every week on video editing, so stay tuned for those. Also, let us know if you have any other video ideas or questions, things you'd want to see on this channel, and we'll see you in the next one.